that Hamilton baby.
Wow, she's very, very hungry.
Give Xiaobai a different plate.
Xiaobai, this is you. Yeah. It's same. Oh, it's same. It's same, baby. It's same food. Oh my god, let's see you, baby. Let's see you. Wow.
He's very dirty.
Yes.
Oh my god.
Very dirty. But oh, no bleeding, no scars, no limping.
Wow, very dirty. Wow, where is this going?
You know what? Here.
Oh, yeah. Oh, maybe I
so
should give the some fish.
It's fine.
Oh.
You don't know what else he might have eaten. Let him eat real food.
But you see, they are very, very hungry.
So let him eat normal food.
Okay. But she can't. They are too.
I know. But right now, this way, he feels protected. You know what I mean?
Oh, yes. Oh, my God.
He's been out there scared. Now he feels protected.
I think she's still outside. It's not in some home. Some neighbors.
He wasn't in anybody else's home. He was outside the whole time.
Oh my god, you are so great, baby. Wow, your brother coming, baby. Are you happy? Are you happy?
No, he's not happy because somebody else is eating. That's all this one cares
about. You're not hungry. Oh my god, that is a very amazing thing happening. Oh my god. Thanks, God.
No, God's the one who led him away in the first place.
God, no.
You probably
God,
don't
no.
want to put that in the video.
小黄太饿了，我又给他加了点餐，把鱼和蛋黄拌在一起。他们挺喜欢吃这种口味的。
That's so close.
长达五个小时的分离。小哥俩现在互相安慰，小白也觉得小黄太脏了，帮他清理一下。其实一进门的时候，我说给小黄洗个澡，我先生说不要再打搅他了，让他安安静静的吃饱喝足休息好，所以我只是拿毛巾湿毛巾用热水给他擦了擦。也许刚刚经历过那种漫长又恐惧的时刻，小黄太累了，很快的就进入到这种深度的睡眠状态，回到了自己的家里，回到了亲人的身边，躺在自己舒舒服服的床上，这样才能够睡一个踏实觉了，我们也可以安心的度过这个夜晚了。小白很懂事，觉得哥哥可能出去经历过什么可怕的事情，所以整个下午和晚上他都比较担心。哥哥回来了，他也不去打搅，就让他安静的在那里睡觉。今天早晨我尝试着把两个小家伙放出来，我就发现小黄有一些惊恐的神态。如果听到狗叫或者外面有大的声音，它会立刻跑进屋里。所以可以肯定的是，昨天一定是被什么给吓着了。有了教训也好，免得他们以后还要往外跑。但是我也非常非常的担心，我要时不时的看着他们是不是还在。现在看来还是我们小白聪明。他知道外面的风险，所以不敢出去。
Come in. 哇哦！
昨天晚上为了找小猫，我先生提着这个包，说一旦在外面发现了，要把它装在里边。他们很喜欢这个旅行包。从今天的观察来看，总体上还是正常的。他们依然会在我做饭的时候躺在这个地垫上，看。 看着我，等待着我给他们给点好吃的。小馋猫，小馋猫，就是嘴馋。
Yes, we bought an expensive padded mat for the kitchen for the cats.
他们也会躺在这里互相按摩，但总之呢，也是希望得到一些好吃的。昨天为了找他们，我拿着零食一边走一边叫一边敲打着零食的盒子。猫爸爸也提着包满街的到处查看，看看路上有没有被碾死的小猫。而且还拿着梯子翻越进了高尔夫球场，在球场里边绕了好几圈，看到的只是一些野兔子。所以昨天到底发生了什么，永远都是个谜，我们永远也搞不清楚，只有我们小黄心里头最明白，但是他说不出来。感谢上帝，感谢朋友们对小黄的牵挂，也感谢朋友们留下的那些宝贵意见，我以后一定要小心，不能够让小猫常出去。他们的小生命已经真正的融入到我们的生活中了。再次感谢大家的收看，我们下期见。